Hola, soy Carissa Gutierrez. Bienvenidos to Latino Center's Viernes Cultural. This is a series that shows how traditional Mexican art and dance lives and breathes in Northern California.
Empecé a bailar tendría unos 8 años. De ahí me entré a un grupo de ballet folclórico ahí en Veracruz, tendría 13 años, de 13 a 18. Lo que pasa es que nos movimos para Veracruz porque mi papá era ayudante de una iglesia, entonces lo movieron de Michoacán para Veracruz, y ahí fue que crecí desde los 8 años hasta que tenía 18 que me casé. Y ya después me casé y pues ya me vine para acá y paré de bailar. Todo empezó porque cuando yo tenía mis niñas, tengo 3, y cuando ya tenían 5 y 6 años, para mí era muy importante que ellas conocieran nuestra cultura de los bailes de nosotros de México. Y yo quería siempre que ellas se sintieran orgullosas como yo me siento de México, y me pensé que era una buena idea transmitirles a México o un poquito de México por medio de los bailes. Y así fue que empecé a ser voluntaria en las elementary school de mis hijas, y empecé a bailar, a enseñarles los bailes.
I feel like we've been dancing our whole lives, as far as I can remember. At first it was just something we had to do because my mom would just tell us like, I'm gonna dress you up and you're gonna go dance, and she would teach us all the steps, and we didn't really have an option. It was more like, we're gonna go get ready, you know? Later on, I started to love it because, I don't know, it just made me so happy to do it. It came naturally. I don't know how to explain it. Like, it wasn't hard to learn the steps. It wasn't hard to like the music. It was just like, I really enjoyed doing it. I'm my sister too. We actually got a lot closer because we danced.
Yeah, for me, I think I always thought it was super cool because they did it, and I thought they were the coolest people I knew. The dance that we're gonna dance later, Madrugada, they it was always just them two dancing it. Like, my mom had this whole group of like girls, but none of them danced the Madrugada. It was always just them.
We told her, leave one song for us, mommy, and just, and everybody can learn the other ones, but leave Madrugada for us.
And I was like 6 years old, and I was in the corner watching them, like trying to mimic their steps. I was stuck with all the 5-year-olds. So they were really lame. I wanted to be cool like them. They were really good for their age.
sufriendo.
Ay, dígame, dígame y dígame usted, ¿cuántas criaturitas se ha chupado usted? Ninguna, 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 no sé, ando en pretensiones de chuparme a usted.
She's also really friendly and outgoing, so it's something that we talk about all the time, actually. She's like, we just watch her sometimes. We'll be dancing, and you know, there's always the people who really enjoy watching it, or they want to learn how to dance, or they think they're not good enough to dance. My mom's that person who just will go up to them. She sees that, she'll go up to them and say, hey, you want to dance in our group? And they're just like, oh my God, I can't dance. She's like, yes, you can dance, you can do this, you know? And that's something I've personally always admired. We've talked about it several times and we're like, we need to be like her, because that's how we've gotten so many people to dance in our group, different ages, different, I mean.
Sometimes you need a little push.
And then they love it. And then they bring their daughters in, and then they bring their family members in. And it's just like, I love that about her. And
she did that with some of my friends. And then she just walked, like, they came over from school and they had to leave early because I had to practice. And their mom was like, oh, stay and learn the dances. And they're like, what? But she was like, and one of my friends did. She ended up joining us. Her name was Ariel. But she came over once, and my mom just like brought out a dress for her and was like, here, put it on. And she just started
dancing. Now she's part of our group.
I saw her as brave, because I'm always shy. And actually, dancing helped me not be as shy. And I know how my mom is too. And I know how I would see her, how she would interact, how she would teach, and I'd be like, wow, like, she's not afraid. Like, so I can not be shy as well. So and then obviously performing, you have to not be somewhat shy. So I saw her as being brave. I saw my mom as being brave.
Hemos pasado por muchas circunstancias. Hemos bailado en cuando hace mucho calor, cuando hace mucho frío, y veces en lugares pequeños, en lugares grandes. Y entonces las experiencias que hemos tenido juntas nos acercan. Y yo pienso que ellas de alguna manera me admiran. Y yo a ellas, nada más que ellas no saben, pero yo las admiro mucho más a ellas por apoyarme en esto de los bailables. La más grande, ella bailó un poco de tiempo en San Francisco como tipo profesional. Cuando vio que yo empecé a dar clases de baile, dejó allá sus clases para ayudarme.
I got to watch people from Mexico come to the U.S. and then I got to watch them dance. I wanted to cry when I saw it, because it's like, you, like, I'm born here, you know, so, sorry. I'm gonna cry. I love dance. I know I was born here, but I feel like I love it as much, you know.
Era de madrugada cuando te empecé a querer. Medianoche, qué loco al amanecer. Era de madrugada cuando te empecé a querer. Un beso a la medianoche, qué loco al amanecer. Era de madrugada.
querer. Un beso a la medianoche, el otro al amanecer. Anoche toda la noche no me ama tu fracalito, a ver si te puede haber por algún agujerito. Anoche toda la noche rodeaba tu flacalito, a ver si te podía ver por algún agujerito. Anoche toda la noche rodeaba tu flacalito, a ver si te podía ver por algún agujerito. Lucero de la mañana, préstame tu claridad para seguirle los pasos a esa joven que hoy se va. Lucero de la mañana, préstame tu claridad para seguirle los pasos a esa joven que hoy se va.
Hace 20 años y no había la oportunidad o no había mucho el maestra de folclórico y por eso pues decidí hacerlo yo. Y ahora pienso que niñas chiquitas entre 6 y 13 años, pienso que son como unas, me animaría a decir 70 niñas, pero son de diferentes escuelas, son 6 escuelas, pero las junto y tengo grupos de baile de entre 5 y 7 años, tengo otro grupo de 8 a 11 y otro de 11 a 13, el de las muchachas ahora de 15 a 20. Pienso que unos 150, porque también en Fairfield el grupo era muy grande. En total pienso que más o menos por ahí. La verdad me ayudan mucho ellas para enseñar. Y ahora que las veo bailar, que me ayudan a enseñar a otros niños, muchas veces lloro en silencio, de gusto, no, es una satisfacción de lo más bonito que me ha pasado.
When I was, I think, 13, after school, my school got about a little bit earlier than the elementary school that she taught at, and she used to pick me up. I used to, like, I came out of class and I ran to my mom's car, and I was like, okay, let's go, and I wanted to teach because all my sisters, like, helped her teach, and my mom said, like, I was 13, I don't think I was even allowed to teach them. But like she gave me a group of little kids and she's like, okay, I'll do this half and you can teach that half. And like, I feel like during that, eventually I went into high school and I got out later and I wasn't allowed to help them anymore. But I feel like I also really liked it, like being out there and to like teach them. So like, I know that's something that I also like to do.
We have actually started picking up like different moves and watching videos and learning about other regions and other places in Mexico so that we're kind of like teamed up to where she does all the footwork, I do choreography, and then we put it together and we tell each other like, this would look really nice and based on like all the research and all of what we've learned from that specific region in Mexico. And
I used to be a part of a group also in the Bay Area. So I would go there. They were very disciplined and that's where I learned. So I learned the fun part with my mom, obviously the love for it. And then I learned the disciplined part in the group.
Kind of meshed it together, yeah, right?
Like they always, like when it came to, like Magdalena makes dances sometimes, like she's the one who choreographs them. And then like Magdalena will make it, she'll like teach it to us, and then we bring Aurora, and then Aurora's like, oh, she's like, you know, it would look prettier if you did this. Or like, she makes it prettier and like cleans it up.
I'm a little bit more strict like with the younger girls. I'm like, okay, chest up, make sure you're smiling, like put your hands, you know, exaggerate a little because it's going to look nice and, you know, when it's live. But
I have three girls, two of them that have officially gotten brave enough to perform. Yeah. First, you want them to do everything, you know, you do. But then you want them to go on their own. My first one, right away,
naturally.
You know, she was like two. My mom on Thanksgiving or Christmas, she would put on a skirt, ponle una falda, you know. And then everyone would take out their phones and say, oh, qué bonita, you know. And then my middle one at first wouldn't. She got stage fright. Mm-hmm. You know, she first song that she was going to perform, instant fright cry and ran off the stage. And obviously you're like, oh, you know, you want them to continue. But she got brave enough and she performs now. And my mom said,
you'll watch them dance.
She said, mija, how does it feel to see your daughters perform? And I was like, it's really nice. It feels really nice. Without Focorico, we got a little taste of it right now during COVID.
It's a big part of what made me who I am. Like, most of these are like, what makes you you? Like, what, like, right now we're talking about like our future, like, who are the person that you are? Like, what's your purpose? Like, what led you up to like now? They're really like starting to talk to us about that and like, oh, what, like, they're trying to figure out what we like to do. And they talk about like our past, like, what we have done to make us who we are. And I always like talk about that because it is what like made me who I was.
Definitely a huge part of my life because I consider myself being a very shy, you know, I don't really talk to a lot of people. Or I think I am, but I think I owe a lot of it to Procorico because I became more confident.
Esa es otra cosa que a mí me da tanto orgullo que trascendió lo que yo empecé hace tantos años y ahora veo mis nietecitas que están chiquitas y ya tienen ese gusto y me da mucho, mucho orgullo que haya yo empezado todo esto. Nada más con verlas a ellas ya como que siento que vale la pena todo el esfuerzo que yo he hecho. Ahora si yo me retiro, ahora estoy segura que mis hijas lo van a seguir y yo con eso es como si yo sigo. Es lo más bonito que yo ahorita siento, que como que ya logré que mis hijas les guste, ya logré que que mis hijas quieran seguir y yo pienso que ellas van a seguir. De ver el fruto, de ver las que tocan, de ver los que bailan, para mí es como cuando terminas algo, cuando algo que tú sueñas, que traes siempre en tu mente, lo terminas, como cuando te gradúas de una carrera. Así siento yo, como cuando te sientes completa.
Yeah.